Today in the news, Google has an iPhone 5C, Oppo brings the optical zoom, and we have some rumors about the 1660 Ti. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Before we start, let me just give a big thanks to our sponsor who makes these videos possible, Memory Express. They're based here in Canada and offer a complete price beat guarantee, not to mention their stores, which are a great place to try out all of the newest peripherals for yourself before you buy them. Check out their online shop in the link down below. It seems like Google really can't keep their phones under wrap. Last year, the Pixel 3 XL got its full unboxing experience leaked in a video, and it seems like the same thing is about to happen for their newest device, the Pixel 3 Lite. While it's still a rumor, a hands-on video has appeared online showcasing the device. Leaked by Android News, the video actually got swiftly removed from their channel, raising some suspicions. Specs-wise, it gets quite the downgrade in processing power. You get a Snapdragon 670 with 4GB of RAM and an Adreno 615 GPU. The camera will apparently be the same as the Pixel 3 with a 12.2MP camera at f1.8. It will also include optical image stabilization. The screen will be slightly bigger than the Pixel 3 at 5.56 inches with a resolution of 2220 by 1080. The battery will be a little bit under 3000 mAh and the body is reminiscent of the unapologetically plastic iPhone 5C. Honestly, it looks like a pretty good buy. The only downside here is the plastic body, the slightly slower CPU, and the lack of the Pixel visual core. They apparently even managed to fit a headphone jack into this little guy. It's all still rumors, but if this is what Google has in store, they might have the perfect high-end Android Pie phone that won't break your bank. Moving on, but still in the smartphone department, Oppo confirmed that it is developing a phone with a zoom lens, not a digital zoom, an actual true 10x telephoto zoom lens. Now, Oppo already showed us a 5x zoom system for a phone camera in 2017, but it never actually made it into a phone. Some could argue that the tech was too immature or just that 5x wasn't enough, but I don't think that they will showcase it again if it wasn't going in a device. The way the lens is placed into the phone is actually super interesting. They will also showcase a new display fingerprint sensor that cover a much larger area of the screen. All of this at the Mobile World Conference next month. What do you guys think about zoom lenses in smartphone? I mean, if you zoom in 10 times, the image is bound to be a lot harder to capture since small hand movements will look like giant swoops in the camera. Let's move on to some GPU news. What do you get if you take an RTX 2060, strip it of its ray tracing abilities, and cut down its CUDA core count? That's right, a 1660 Ti apparently. According to Videocardz, this new GPU will feature a 12 nanometer TU116 chip. It will have 24 compute units for a total of 1536 CUDA cores and will stick to 6GB of GDDR6 memory. That's 384 less CUDA cores than the RTX 2060 and still without any ray tracing or tensor cores. If this comes to life, it's going to be a little bit weird to have a 1660 Ti without ever having a non-TI version. Nvidia did say that they are nearing the end of stock for their GTX 1060, so once those are gone, be prepared for their next gen of non-ray tracing cards. At this point, I don't think that we'll see another RTX card. Going any lower than the RTX 2060 would be a bit nonsensical, but it's interesting to see that Nvidia still wants to create a divide between the RTX and non-RTX cards by cutting down the CUDA core count on the 1660 Ti. I'm pretty sure that if this card comes out, we can say goodbye to the idea of having non-ray tracing cards in the high end of things. What do you guys think about my theory? If they kept the CUDA core count the same for the 1660 Ti, it would probably be as fast as the RTX 2060 in rasterized gaming, at which point, gamer would just avoid the RTX cards. If we go up to, let's say, an RTX 2070, remove the ray tracing, and cut down the CUDA cores, we're now at RTX 2060 levels of rastered performance, at which point pricing the card would be impossible given the cards available currently. Basically, offering a non-ray tracing 2070 would make no sense for Nvidia if they still want their lineup to make sense. It could make a little more sense for the 2080 if, let's say, they make it $600 for 2560 CUDA cores, but it's still shaky at this point. I just just think that Nvidia will keep non-ray tracing chips for the mid to low end tiers. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video, right here to subscribe to the channel, it would be greatly appreciated. Don't forget to drop a like down below, stay frosty, and I'll see you guys on the next one. My voice keeps cracking and I have to redo certain parts of the video, so there's gonna be a lot of jump cuts here. All right, take care, guys.